we are about to embark on our first trip with Burrito on the Eurotunnel.
On the Eurotunnel.
What are you thinking? What are you feeling?
Nervous as per usual.
You'll be fine.
Of course I'll be fine.
Right, so...
We know this has been filmed before, but this is for us to say, remember that time we went on the Eurotunnel for the first time in Burrito? So yeah, this is...
for us.
Coming around the corner.
Right, I'm gonna...
going down onto the station platform in a minute. Lots of Swifts around.
There certainly is.
Where's the Auto Trail gang?
Auto Trail, where are you?
Oh, it looks like they're queuing up, so... we'll film when we go in onto... I know where I've got to go. We'll film when we go onto the actual train itself.
This is it. We are off. We are filming. Turn off your headlights. I ain't got them on. Oh, it's so exciting!
It is really exciting. Delay.
This is the truth of whether you can get your butt on that thing.
Come round, boy, come round. Go. Oh. It's interesting. I'm not talking a lot because we're stunned and we're ready to get on the tunnel.
Ooh. I can always put music on.
You can.
Do 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 do
do do do do do do do. Hello, hello. Listen carefully, I was say this only once.
Where is your beret?
Yeah,
and your baguette?
I was passing by your door.
Classic.
Classic. Classic. Is it gone? Oh, we're starting to move again.
Oh.
I am so nervous. I'm not nervous about getting on, but it's just the full journey.
You'll be fine. You're doing so well.
So.
Right, here we go. So we are going to get our arse on.
Come round. Come round,
Tiggy
boy, come round. There you go.
Oh, like a pro, babe, like a pro.
Well, you'd think so.
Hey, are you pleased with that?
Anyone nervous about getting... oh, we're in a 7.8 metre up with the bikes.
Oh, yeah.
Doddle, absolute doddle. I was nervous about that bit, but no, happy with that. Yeah, plenty of room. Each side. I mean, we've got the wide mirrors. Some people have the shorter ones. We've got the long mirrors. Loads of room. Absolutely loads of room.
Oh, I'm all proud. Yeah. Well done.
So am I. So we will see you...
in...
France! Yes.
Bye. And we...
please drive to highlight a point.
...are in France! Yay!
Sunny France!
It is sunny as well. Thank you.
I like it. Don't forget, drive on the right hand side.
Drive on the right hand side, Kev. Sorte! Exit. I am now French. Je suis français.
Turn right onto Avenue de France.
It's alright, wasn't it, babe? It is.
In 1.5 miles, A16. Right to A16.
They're saying 50, I don't know, 50 is.
50 kilometres, isn't it?
Yeah. They're saying 31. 31 miles an hour, it's 51 kilometres, or 50 kilometres now. So I'm breaking the speed
limit. Oh, naughty kid.
And then going on to. Is this the A6 then? Oh no, this is the passenger one.
Possibly. Ooh la la, please keep to the right. Turn here, Edward.
Yeah.
Calais, Prague, A6 Brussels, Boulogne, and Paris. Following everyone at the minute. A16, yeah.
We're all good.
In 3/4 mile, keep right to A16.
Bienvenue en France.
Bienvenue.
Non. Bienvenue. Okay, so I'm sure you've seen enough of this road now.
Yeah, we're in France.
We are in France. Yay! Right, see you later, people.
Time to concentrate.
Yeah, bye bye. Okay, so we're on the road, we're in France, off to our first campsite. We've just had to try out now. Now, why have we had to try out an air, Kev?
Remember the Renogy multi-flex panels a couple of videos ago? And I said, that's tar, that's not coming off. Well, if you're driving in a very warm country and you've got, shun the traffic. It's got a lot of traffic. When lorries start overtaking other lorries, there's big long lines of lorries and bits and pieces, and you're getting buffered all over the place, and you're overtaking and bits and pieces like that. Yeah, I think the wing turbulence gets underneath the solar panel, because as we were driving over, we were tap, 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 tap.
Tap, tap, bang, 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 bang,
and I'm thinking, oh my God. And it suddenly dawned on me. We thought it was a cupboard door was rattling. That's what it sounded like first of all. Nah, it was the corner of the solar panel. Just literally, I can't get out of my roof. I needed to bring my ladders. So if you're ever going on a trip or anything like that, bring some kind of ladder to get up on the roof, because you never know when you're gonna need them. So I've sort of like hung out of the sky vent with a broom and really pushed down on that corner. I mean, luckily enough, it was only one corner. But once we get to this next campsite, Pierce and whatever, we're going to see if we can borrow a set of ladders so I can get out there and jump up and down on the solar panel. Because apparently they're really strong.
We're going to put that to the test.
Yeah, or I'm going to have to find a space somewhere and just stick a screw in it for now. I've got no... What did I say in the video as well about...
Sikaflex.
Yeah, always, real camper van and now I've got Sikaflex. I did bring it with me.
It's in the other.
It's in the other car. So yeah, so that's just an update. Air's coming really handy because they're everywhere along here. And we just had to pull in. But I'm hoping, if you can't hear any tapping,
no.
I'm only doing 57 miles an hour. And I'm just literally, this is going to be such a long journey now, because I'm supposed to be doing about 68 miles an hour. So this is really going to add to it. Yeah, it's not good. So yeah, that's our update so far along the travels. I'm just playing with the lorries now.
But you live and you learn, and it's all about the journey, not the destination.
Yeah, we said that before, didn't we? It's all about the journey.
Okay. So, but the weather's good.
Weather's good. It's hot.
It's very hot, isn't
it? I'm just wondering whether that's got something to do with it, like, because I said it's like tar, and I'm wondering whether it got so hot that as we're travelling, the tires just started to melt a little bit more. But I don't know. Again, I think it's a mixture. It's the heat melted the tire a little bit, and the amount of lorries that we've just been overtaking.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's, yeah, live and learn, as you say.
Right. Say goodbye, Kevin. Oh, Kev.
He
is gonna divorce me. Okay, so see you hopefully at the campsite, and there's no more little foibles just to give us some fun. Bye. I'm gonna show you a typical traffic jam on our horrendous journey through France.
Hello. Is anyone there? Oh, here we go.
Oh, no. That's the noise that we can hear.
That's the solar panel.
Yeah. Okay. Right, we're going to stop it now. Just wanted to share the view with you people. It's starting to look really good. Excuse the noise of the flapping.
It's turned from a banging to a flapping sound.
Yeah.
So I think it's snapped. Same snap.
Yeah. And until we can see what's going on, well, we're stopping in about half an hour. We'll then be at our destination for tonight. Have a look at this view. In a bit. Just want to show you these lovely sunflowers. Don't know if it's going too fast for you to see them. But they're on. Lovely sunflowers. And they always turn towards the sun, so when we drive back they'll be doing a different thing, or they'll all be withered and old, just like our arm feeling. Nice cool now, but beautiful roads, absolutely stunning.
And that's after I've done out the solar panel to the roof.
Oh, I don't think it's giving us grief, people. Really giving us grief. Not happy. It is what it is. We've got how many more miles left?
About 200.
200 more miles with occasional bang, bang, banging. It's not stressful at all. Really not.
See if the guy's got a lad or something, we'll probably get there, but we're not going to get there until 20 past 5.
Yeah. Well, it doesn't shut till 7, so let's just hope someone's feeling really nice, lends us a ladder so Kev can get up on top and what's the name?
Stamp on it.
Or rip it off.
Yeah, rip it off.
All right, say goodbye, Kev.
Bye, Kev.
See you later. Hello, good morning from France. Okay, so we are in Volvic and didn't really want to film last night. We'd done 12 hours on the road and we were shattered. Quite grumpy for reasons that will become apparent in a moment. Okay, so I'm going to give you a tour and show you around the only camp we stayed in. Wasn't a great experience, but it could have been due to tiredness and what happened when we got here. All right, so I'm going to take you on a tour. So, this is your entrance. Okay, there is a barrier. And this is Camping Volvic Pierre et Source. Okay, so you want to come here, you're more than welcome, but I wouldn't if you're I'd say a comfort motorhome, but not a bigger motorhome. They don't take twin axle anyway, but yeah, three star. where we're going in Spain is faster, and I'm hoping for so much better. Right, okay, so there you've got your payment and your entry. When we went into, oh, and there's your bins, look. Okay. Then we've got reception. Okay. So this morning, I have ordered two baguettes before we leave. So at 8 o'clock, we can come and get those baguettes. It's obligatory. If you're in France, you've got to have a baguette. It's like the law. So yes, so this is reception. It's all quiet at the moment because obviously, oh, defib. I love to always point out the defib. Got to have your dog on a lead. And this is the campsite. Now, we are in pitch one. Don't do it, and I'll show you why in a moment. Okay, so notice board, and let's go for a walk. So there's like a communal area, and I think there's like a seating indoor area. I was told by the receptionist yesterday that there's a like little market that goes on in there sometimes with all regional produce and stuff. But as you can see, little seating out area. It was very busy when we arrived. So now, hindsight's an amazing thing, and I wish we would have parked here. Because I will show you why you shouldn't park in pitch one, but we'd already driven round once, couldn't see any free park-ups. Was told by when we arrived at reception, oh, I'll just go and find a pitch. It's not your camping and caravanning or your camping and motorhome club where you get a little person that actually shows you to your pitch. Europe's very different, as we are discovering. Remember, we're newbies, and yeah. So let's show you to our pitch. So it's a small triangle, and there is Kev, who's very sad this morning, aren't you, Kev? Look what we did to Burrito.
That's just dirt.
But yes.
I thought it was only that.
That is, we're a bit more positive. Last night, as I say, we weren't fit for filming. I was crying, and I just thought.
I found some white tape, some matches.
But today we can think clearer, more positively.
Lesson I've learned from this is, when you're coming onto your pitch, don't let anyone hurry you up. Because that's what happened to me yesterday. I'm not blaming anyone else, it's my fault. Full disclosure, my fault. I took my eye off the ball as I'm driving in. The van behind me was like, come then, hurry up. And I was watching this corner, and I was clear to here. And all I did was move forward and then looked in the rear view mirror to see where the van was in case I needed to back up. Boom, that's when it happened. Straight as soon as I took my eye off that crunch, done. Never let anyone rush you.
And obviously, as you'll see earlier in the other video, or this video, we had the satellite on the roof that's flapped onto the other solar panel. So we haven't even got solar now because it's gone the other way.
It's gone south.
So we had a... Oh, it was horrendous, and I'm not great with noisy sounds. Anyway, this is your electric.
It's almost disappeared.
Got our angles malts on. But I'll carry on with the tour, babe. You carry on with your, you know, your plaster of Paris and
it
all
looks
that.
As good as new, come on.
Yeah, I think we might need to see someone about that. Okay. She's sort of looking good. She looks filthy. But, right, so let's take you around the campsite. So don't go and pitch one, is our advice. I mean, stunning scenery. I mean, there's something up there. I'm sure it's very important and historic. Lots of tenting, small caravans, etc. If you see those girls, they were the horrible teenagers that were laughing at Kevin when he hit the van. They are now learning the D-head phrase on their Google Translates because they were really taking the mick. Not nice people. If someone's like, you know, pride and joy and they smash it, don't laugh at them. It's not very nice. So as you can see, all little like caravan ways. And unlike us, the gravel is for driving in and out. Where we're used to gravel pitches in England, we parked on it and then had a very difficult French conversation trying to work out what they was saying to us, and it was basically you need to be on the grass, not on the gravel. Okay, so yeah, some nice little private bits as well. I would like to, if we have more time, walk up to there. I'm sure that's like for the energetic people. So yeah, some people were here longer stay. Ours is just an overnight because obviously our final destination is Spain, where we can see Madre y Padre, en Alicante, Costa Blanca. So we're looking forward to that. And today we move on to a campsite in Masterat, I think. Okay, but yeah, so there's a big pitch which would have been more suitable for us. So you've got these, like, I think they're called safari lodges, and it looks like there's some kind of tennis courts, whether that's anything to do with here or whether it's the local community or sports center, I'm not sure. I've got to confess, it feels nice and calm this morning. Last night when we arrived, it was so chaotic. And I think after a long drive, well, 12 hours, it just felt really shambolic. But look, tents. Absolutely perfect for tents. And I do like these safari lodges. They're quite cute. A park, like parking area, I suppose, just for the safari lodges. I think if you've got a young family and you're doing things on a budget, I think this would probably be ideal. As I say, we were just a little bit unlucky with things that were going wrong yesterday, but that's part and parcel of motorhoming. It can't all be fun and sun and everything else. You've got to take the rough with the smooth. It's just life, you know. But we're happier today. So yeah, more lodges. They look more like your chalet style. And I think we're back to the beginning. Yeah. Sorry about the flip-flop noise. Kevin's going to moan about flip-flop noise. Oh, I think I've just found a barbecue area. Oh, they're your facilities as well, like your shower blocks. And I think there's a barbecue area here. picnic tables, barbecue area. Again, like little hives. Yeah, so it's bigger than I initially thought. Yeah, I won't go down there, but yeah. Well, I will go down there. Still early morning. Shouldn't be too many people around. Oh, you pop wash. Bac à vaisselle et chaud. Okay, and it's got hot water, so basic, but all what you need. Yeah. Oh, laundry room. Sorry, it's a bit dark. I don't think you're going to be able to see that. And then let's go back. So yeah, so that's everything. On that note, I'm going to leave you after that tour. Okay. Our opinion, and it is only our opinion, you might have come here and had a wonderful experience. Don't bother. I really wish now that we'd have just used airs through the front bit. We was literally needing to put our head down. So, waste of money really. I think it was about €28 in total. With the tax, but yeah, I think in the future we'd use an air, and that way you can look at them, suss whether you feel all right there, and go from there. So we're learning, we're new, but yeah, airs in France I think is the way to go for us, and then in Spain, where I can speak the language a little bit, it's easier. I know words in French and a couple of small sentences, but I don't know enough to get by. And that's on us. That's not on them. That's on us. And I'm your language person. Kevin has lots of skills. Language might not be one of them.
may we? Petit pois. I'll speak French.
He speaks Del Boy French. He still doesn't understand the masculine and the feminine. That just blows his mind.
What makes a chair a female? And a table a female? I understand washing machines and stuff like that. They're definitely female.
So sexist. Misogynistic sod. Right, okay. So I'm going to leave it there.
We're going to end the video on this one. End the vlog on this one, yeah? Love because. So we're going to love and leave you. Hold my keys because I'm going to smash them in the front, thing up. And love and leave you. Next time you see us, we'll be probably.
Happier in Spain.
Yeah, on our way down to Spain. Probably go across Spanish border. Yeah.
Oh, but yeah, we'll show you the Pyrenees.
Yeah. All right. So we'll speak to you soon. Have fun.